So what were some of your coping mechanisms for dealing with your colorblindness in the lab?
First off, avoid having to do the things that might be most challenging.
This is Patrick Stanley. He's a graduate student at the University of Maryland, College Park. He studies materials used in solid oxide fuel cells, which convert fuel directly into electricity and are more efficient than conventional internal combustion engines. He's also red-green colorblind.
And then in the end, you know, it's just kind of take the hit to your pride and go to somebody else and say, what color is this?
A company called Enchroma is now offering an alternative, glasses that use optical filters to help people with impaired color vision distinguish colors. We know these glasses won't cure color blindness, but we asked Stanley to try them on and tell us how helpful they are in the lab.
So first impressions, look around the room, what are you seeing or not seeing?
Everything feels kind of like I'm looking through rose-colored glasses.
Okay.
Just a little pink-purpley-ish, maybe. I've always had trouble with the color purple.
Okay.
I'm kind of convinced it doesn't exist.
Before heading down to the lab, we asked Stanley to look at samples of one of his solid oxide fuel cell materials, yttria stabilized zirconia. These lustrous, whitish materials that he worked with all the time took on a new dimension with the glasses on.
These are more blue than I remember them being. I don't know if that's the base on the glasses or what, but those are blue to me.
It was time to set Stanley free in his lab, wearing the Enchroma glasses. Here's his reaction.
There were some simple things that really caught my attention. Just primary colors seemed more their color, and that's just labels and boxes and things. They caught my attention more, and I guess that's the point of a hazardous label, is to catch my attention. I also really noticed LED colors. I never noticed that these temperature controllers had different, you know, the top was red, the bottom was green for numbers. I'm astounded. I've never been able to tell really between red and green LEDs.
Stanley also told us that he was able to more quickly distinguish between colors on the computer screen while wearing the glasses, so he definitely noticed an improvement in his work. The glasses start at about $250 a pair, a little more than many high-end normal sunglasses. Is that investment worth the improvement Stanley was seeing?
I've positioned myself in a place where my colorblindness does not impact my daily job. But if it was something that I really wanted to do and it was an impact to me, I would consider these. For me right now and what I do, it's a luxury.
For Chemical and Engineering News, I'm Craig Bettenhausen.